shop and the store, put the lock on the door. Just get away where your worries won't find you. If you like, well, I'll tell you more. Don't let the day get the better of you. When the evening comes, there's so much to do. You better put on your best and wear a smile. Just come along with me a while, 'cause I tell you,
we've just arrived at Cherry Tree Hill
Winery. We've driven past this place so many times on our way home from being away. Anyway, we thought we would come in for a tasting. Looking forward to taking our masks off. Anyway, what a cute little venue. And there's some little birds singing.
All around there are girls and boys. It's a swinging place. A cellar full of noise, it's got an atmosphere of its own somehow. You gotta come along right now, 'cause I tell you, I know a place where the music is fine and the lights are always low. I know a place where we can go.
So we've just arrived at our first stop for our little trip away, and I wish I knew how to pronounce the town. It's spelled J-U-G-I-O-N-G, so I don't know if it's Jugiong or Jugiong or Jugiong. Anyway, we're going to the Sir George tonight for dinner, so I will ask the staff. Cockatoos are flying around. Steve's got his drone up. Now, we're walking tonight to Sir George, and I believe it's just through the clump of trees over there. It's just on the other side. So we have a short walk to where we're going to have a lovely romantic dinner celebrating 31 years of marriage. Very lucky.
You'll never see a dark cloud hanging round me. Now there is only blue sky to surround me. There's never been a gray day since you found me. Everything I touch is turning to gold. So you can cover my world with sunshine yellow each day. Up above me, since I found the one who really loves me, everything I touch is turning to gold.
So we've just been walking from the showground, which is a free camp, to the Sir George. Nice easy walk. Be interesting what it'll be like later tonight. Didn't bring a torch, but we can always use our mobile phones. Just got a little bridge here, and there's a park. Pretty little park. And yeah, just beyond here should be where we need to go. So there's a wine cellar across the road, and that's our lovely the Sir George. Look looking forward to having a look around it and enjoying the food. What do you think, Steve?
It's fantastic.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary, Dom.
When you're alone and life is making you lonely, you can always go downtown. When you've got worries, all the noise and the hurry seems to help, I know. Downtown, just listen to the music of the traffic in the city. Linger on the sidewalk where the neon signs are pretty. How can you lose? The lights are much brighter there. You can't forget all your troubles, forget all your cares, so go downtown.
Absolutely spectacular. Look at this. It's a beautiful tree in the center, but it's got vines growing all around on a frame. And I've left my lover over here because I'm just loving this garden. It's beautiful. And the thickness of these vines going up the poles is incredible. And here he is.
Who loves you, pretty baby? Who's gonna love you, mama? Who loves you, pretty baby? And when you think the whole wide world has passed you by, you keep on trying, but you really don't know why.
Out above Jugiong, and that's how apparently you pronounce it. We had a fantastic night at the Sir George, and the accommodation there looks amazing. So if you don't have a caravan, maybe stay the night and enjoy a fantastic meal. The atmosphere is amazing. And if you have a caravan or a tent, you can just camp across the road in the showground for free by the river, by the Murrumbidgee River.
Am I living? Oh, what a funny thing to say. But there's alive and then there's living. Am I living for today?
Well, here we are at one of our favourite camping spots. This is Thomas Boyd Trackhead, not far from Tumut. And it's on the Goobra Gandra River, also known as the Goob. And there's been a lot of rain lately, so the river is flowing. I'll just come down here. This is And the grass has grown so much since we were here Christmas time. Yeah, it'd be interesting. Last time we were here, we had our rubber tubes and we floated down the river. But yeah, I don't know if I'd even be able to stop with the flow of the water at the moment. So yeah, such a beautiful location. Yeah, definitely. So when we were here last, it was actually clear, you could see through it. This is a beautiful little camping spot as well down here, but no car access, you've got to walk it in. But yeah, it's going very fast. Some nice rapids down there. It's nice to be back. It's lovely and warm. And that's us just up there. A little track.
Am I living for today? And I'm getting older with every memory I make. Now that I'm older with these moments, will I live for them or just throw them away? Away.
Bitch, your mama always said, look up into the sky, find the sun on a cloudy day. Bitch, your mama always said, look up into the sky, find the sun on a cloudy day. On a cloudy day.
Bitch, your mama always said, look up into the sky, find the sun on a cloudy day.
Moving. And the water is moving very fast. Just putting our lamb on. Do you want to just lift the lid on it? Yeah, that's going to be fantastic. Yeah, so we're doing a camp oven roast and veg. Hey, Stevie. So coals on the top and the bottom. Perfect. Okay, checking our lamb roast, see how it's going. Oh, ho, 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 ho. That looks so good. Oh, I can't wait. Oh, wow. That looks lovely. Got Brussels sprouts. Oh, look at the potatoes. They look really good. Pumpkin and our...
Like this.
on a track that we just decided to take. And we're high on a hill again, overlooking the Flowering Dam area. It's gorgeous. So we're at the Orient Hotel in Tumut and I'm just doing a gin tasting at Pretty Parrot. Pretty Parrot is actually downstairs, but today you can come up to the bar and Steve's having a beer. Cheers. So the gins I've got today are bathtub gin, which has got aniseed in it. There's lemon myrtle, which I know I'm going to love. There's a ruby gin and there's a rhubarb and pomegranate gin. Can't wait. Anyway, I just wanted to do a little correction that we're at the Oriental Hotel, not the Orient. So, yeah, there you go. It's pretty good. Tumut Brewery, having their paddle, different beers. We've got a Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Trying
to think of names.
A UMIPA.
Full Grunt. And what's the
Bad Mofo.
Bad Mofo. They are delicious. There he is. Hello, mister. Yeah, he's just dug in. Beautiful.
I like watching the puddles gathering. And all like...
Well, welcome to Mama Gibbo's Caravan Kitchen. I am going to make some cabbage rolls to go with our dinner, and what I'm going to do is fry up some mushrooms with onion. I'm then going to add some grated carrot, Italian herbs, some nutritional yeast flakes, which for say a vegan is substitute for parmesan cheese. It's quite amazing, this stuff. Add a bit of salt and pepper, and also some Ben's rice. I've bought a tomato basil flavor, and so that's my filling. I'm going to boil some water and I'm going to blanch my cabbage leaves for about 2 minutes till they become a bit soft so I can put my filling in and roll them. Anyway, I'm going to get started. Okay, so I've got my onion, mushroom, grated carrot and the nutritional yeast has been fried in that fry pan. Now with this rice, you generally just have to add 30 grams of water, but I'm just going to add it straight to my fry pan. If I feel like it's a little bit dry, I've got a little bit of tomato juice that I'll pop in there. 30 mil possibly. Now I've got my water boiling, and to blanch your cabbage leaves, you just drop it in the boiling water for about 2 minutes and then take them out to drain and they will soften nicely. Okay, so I've got my Ben's rice all mixed in there with the Italian herbs as well. I've got my last cabbage leaf just boiling sort of 1 to 2 minutes until they're lovely and lime green like that. And I'm almost ready to put it together. I will let them cool down just a little bit, otherwise I'll burn. Okay, so it's time to put my delicious filling into my cabbage and roll them. So I'm going to bring my camera closer so you can see what I'm doing.
I'm insane. It's not sane. It's not sane.
and then roll like that. So that's it. That's my little cabbage roll. Pop that there, and what we're going to do is cook them on the barbecue. Well, how easy was that? My stuffed cabbage rolls. We're going to cook these tonight on the hot plate. Can't wait. Thanks for watching. Oh, hello.
Hi.
The rain is coming down, so we've got our marquee up now and just enjoying the fire. It's working well. Thanks. Well, here we are at Thomas Boyd Trackhead and it is raining.
The goob.
So we've put the marquee up, but we still can enjoy the fire. So that's good. I'm gonna have a good night. Got nowhere to go, and yeah, got some delicious food to cook for dinner as always. Cheers. Trying to feed the kookaburras.
Not having any part of it.
Not having any part of it. They're up there. They were just singing beautifully. Very Australian. Come on, cookers, show us what you're made of. Beautiful. Just enjoying Friday afternoon at our campsite on the Gubragandra River. Oh, look at this, it's spectacular. Had kookaburras singing just before. Little bit of precipitation, which is ease. We've got our marquee up to stay dry, but doesn't that look beautiful? The Gubragandra River, and the locals call it the Goob, which is much easier to say. It is running so fast. So last time we were here, you could actually see the pebbles at the bottom, but now you can't. Steve's going to still go in the water. I don't want him to, and I know that I wouldn't be able to stop myself on the tube. Could be quite comical, but it could also be tragic. Not gonna happen. But look at the mist up on the hills. It is a lovely, lovely afternoon. Lovely to be outdoors and camping again. Isn't it good to be camping again, Steve?
It's fantastic.
Stevie bought a new hat.
It's the best.
It's awesome. Bought that in Tumut.
There's shade under here for
everybody.
Whole country.
I love it. Good on you. Yeah, magic. Found some firewood.
We've just come back up from the river. Not a very far walk. I would call it a short walk. To be sure. And a really good fire. The running water and the water. Crackle of the fire.
The streets are dark. Is it any wonder? Are we fall apart day after day? Strange rain falls down.
Yummy fresh pizza from our barbecue.
Rain coming, it's been raining.
So we've just arrived at Bradgrave Lookout near Marulan. It's a bit of a drop down to that point. It's pretty amazing countryside. You can see the mist rising.
This is just a camp. This is just a spot on Wiki Camps. Has just got a sign. Nobody's written anything about it.
Ah.
I think they have that one up there.
Lost.
This will end up going back up
to the camp, the picnic area.
Yeah, so I think this is it.
Oh, that's a camp spot.
Spot there.
Right. What do you reckon? Do you feel safe?
Yeah.
So here we are at Pemrose State Forest. This is just a random free camp we have just found, which is halfway between where we were and going home. So to get a head start for tomorrow. I'm not frightened, but we are very close to Belanglo State Forest and you know those stories. Anyway, hopefully we have no visitors tonight except wombats, because there's wombat holes everywhere. We've seen kangaroos on the way in. We're not far from the main road. But yeah, we've got this lovely cleared area, and that's the road up there that we need to get out on when we go tomorrow. So yeah, our last night for our little escape. It's sprinkling just a little bit, but we found last night it was good just having this little marquee up that we can sit on the edge in front of the fire.
Psycho killer, escassé.
Listen to that.
And I know I'm right. For the first time in my life, that's why I tell you, you'd better be home soon.